Balin, son of Fundin, was born in 2763, making him just 7 years old when the dragon Smaug sacks his home of Erebor in 2770. 2 years later, his brother Dwalin is born while the dwarves are in exile. It is likely he was born in Dunland, where many of the dwarves of Erebor temporarily settled. The brothers are distantly related to Thorin, all three having descended from Nain II, their great-great-grandfather. Today on Nerd of the Rings, we're continuing our look at the dwarves of Thorin's company with Dwalin and Balin. Fundin, the father of Balin and Dwalin, would die much younger than his sons. He fought in the War of the Dwarves and Orcs and was killed at 137 years old in the Battle of Azanabulzar, the final battle of the war. Balin was also present at the battle, though his role is unknown. Being 36 years old at the time, it's possible that he fought in the battle as well. We'll cover this war in greater depth in the final video of the series when we cover Thorin. After the war, the brothers return with King Thrain II to their home in Dunland. Shortly afterwards, in 2802, they relocate to Eriador, where they colonize the arid Luin, the Blue Mountains. This is the realm that Thorin, Balin, and Dwalin, and many other dwarves would call home for a number of years. Though they now had a new home in the Blue Mountains, King Thrain longs to return to Erebor. After 39 years in the Blue Mountains, he launches an expedition to their former home in 2841. Balin and Dwalin and a few other dwarves join him on this journey. However, they would never reach the mountain. Sauron sets his sights on the new king in his eagerness to take the Ring of Thror. The company is harassed by wolves, orcs, and evil birds on their journey. One night in 1845, as the group crosses the Anduin River, an evil rain forces them into the Eaves of Mirkwood and the company is split. Thrain is never seen again. Balin and Dwalin return to the Blue Mountains to inform Thorin, who now becomes the new king of the line of Durin. The Quest of Erebor. In 2941, Gandalf is attempting to persuade Thorin to take Bilbo on the quest. Balin, who is present at the meeting, inadvertently ensures Bilbo's participation. When Gandalf states that professional stealth is needed and defends hobbits in general, Balin jumps to the conclusion that Bilbo is a trained treasure hunter and a thief. Thorin agrees to meet the hobbit, which they do when the dwarves arrive at the meeting at Bag End. Balin is now 178 years old, and Dwalin 169, when they embark on the quest to reclaim the Lonely Mountain. As the company awaits Bilbo at the Green Dragon, it is Dwalin who tells Bilbo he will have to manage without pocket handkerchiefs and a good many other things before journey's end. Within the company, Balin often takes the role of lookout. In fact, it is when Bilbo, wearing the One Ring, sneaks past Balin after they escape the goblin tunnels that Balin begins to develop a great respect for the hobbit. His growing fondness of Bilbo is noticeable after the hobbit saves the dwarves from the spiders. When they finally get the story of Gollum and the ring from Bilbo, Balin is finally satisfied with how Bilbo sneaked past him earlier and starts calling him good old Bilbo. When Thorin is captured by the elves of Mirkwood, Balin becomes the spokesdwarf of the group, being the second oldest of the company. His angry answers to Thranduil lead to their imprisonment as well. Balin's fondness of Bilbo is exemplified further when he is the only dwarf to accompany Bilbo down the passageway into Erebor the first time he descends into the mountain. Balin waits partway down the passageway and delightedly carries the tired hobbit back to the door. Later, when Bilbo drops his torch, it's Balin who says it's the dwarves' turn to help. We see a similar sentiment in the film version of The Hobbit when Thorin says they won't go down the tunnel to help the burglar.
I will not risk this quest for the life of one burglar.
Bilbo. His name is Bilbo.
This is one of the relationships from the book that I think is best presented in the films. Ken Stott's Balin is an absolute delight, and his fondness for Bilbo is one of the most endearing character traits of any of the dwarves in the film. As with my previous video, we'll take a moment to look at some of the traits of these characters found in The Hobbit Chronicles in an effort to better appreciate their film incarnations. Fortunately, we have a lot more information on Dwalin and Balin from Tolkien himself, so this will be a much more brief section of this video. If you want to stick with just the Tolkien canon, you can skip to the timecode here. In the Hobbit films, one of the biggest tweaks for Dwalin and Balin, along with Thorin, are their ages. In reality, Balin was 17 years younger than Thorin, with Thorin being 24 years old when Smaug took the mountain. In the film, the ages of Balin, Dwalin, and Thorin seem to have been altered, with Thorin and Dwalin appearing close in age and being described as having grown up together and being sparring partners. Balin comes across as more of a father figure to Thorin, rather than being the younger of the two. In the last video, we talked about Dori being a mother hen to Ori. It turns out he isn't the only one looking after the company's weakest member. Actor Graham McTavish states in The Hobbit Chronicles, Dwalin has a soft spot for Ori, who he quietly admires for being so determined to come on the quest against the wishes of his family. He protects the naive young dwarf in battle and keeps a watchful eye on him throughout the journey. I think Dwalin admires this youngest, weakest member of the company, who is, nevertheless, willing to risk his life. We see this in several moments throughout the films, as Dwalin often assists or keeps an eye out for Ori. Now that we know some distinctives for the films, let's make our way back to the pages of The Hobbit. When the company reaches Ravenhill, Balin states that he knew many ravens of the rocks when he was a dwarf lad. Specifically, Kark and his wife. Kark's son, Roek, is now chief of the ravens, and 153 years old himself. He recognizes Balin, the son of Fundin, as well as Thorin, the son of Thrain, and shares the news from the thrush that Smaug is dead. Balin and Dwalin both fight in and survive the ensuing Battle of Five Armies. In the fall of 2949, Balin and Gandalf come to the Shire to visit Bilbo. The three friends talk for hours, with Balin sharing the news of the Kingdom Under the Mountain and the restored town of Dale. Dwalin makes Erebor his permanent home, possibly fighting in the Battle of Dale with King Dane Ironfoot during the Lord of the Rings, and living well into the Fourth Age. He dies in year 91 at the age of 340, the latest known death date of any of Thorin's company. Balin makes Erebor his home for a time, but while his brother would live to a very old age, Balin would meet a much more tragic end. The expedition to Moria. Though the reclamation of Erebor made the dwarves prosperous once again, many dwarves longed to return to Moria. Balin mounts an expedition in 2989 to reclaim his second fallen dwarven realm, despite King Dane counseling against it. The expedition hoped to not only reclaim the treasure of Moria, but also the Ring of Thror, which they believed Thror had lost when he entered Moria before the War of the Dwarves and Orcs. The expedition also included Ori and Óin, in addition to Floy, Frar, Loni, Nali, and many other unnamed dwarves. After a short battle with orcs in which Floy kills an orc chieftain before falling himself, they enter the Great Gates, the doorway that the Fellowship would exit 30 years later. Balin sets up his throne in the Chamber of Mazarbul, taking his title, Lord of Moria. For roughly 5 years, the colony did quite well. They found old treasures, mithril, and armories. They sent messengers to Erebor to update their kin on the happenings in Moria. However, news suddenly stops, and the dwarves of Erebor receive no further news out of Moria, as we learn from Gloin and Gimli when they report at the Council of Elrond. Things take a turn for the worse on November 10th, 2994. Balin travels alone to look in the Miromir, where an orc archer hiding behind a rock kills him with an arrow. The dwarves kill the archer, but orc reinforcements come up the Silverlode River. After a short battle, the dwarves rescue Balin's body and retreat back into the First Hall and bar the East Gate. Eventually, the orcs capture the Bridge of Khazad-dûm and the Second Hall.
They have taken the bridge and the Second Hall. We have barred the gates, but cannot hold them for long.
Óin takes a group west, hoping to find escape through the doors of Durin, but is killed by the Watcher in the Water. Just four of his group return. Trapped on both sides, the remaining dwarves, including Ori, retreat to the Chamber of Mazarbul. They place Balin's body in a tomb in the chamber, his final resting place. Ori and the remaining dwarves die in their last stand, the only dwarves to know of Balin's fate. 25 years later, the Fellowship passes through Moria, coming to the chamber. Upon seeing the words on the tomb, Balin, son of Fundin, Lord of Moria. Gimli casts his hood over his face in his grief, the first of his people to learn of the death of Balin. As Gimli grieves, Frodo thinks back to the friendship of Bilbo and Balin. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next video as we continue our series on the Dwarves of Erebor here on Nerd of the Rings.